One of the areas that we were never satisfied with in the first generation of the fuselage was the door arrangement. Both the hinge geometry wasn't quite where it needed to be, and the door locking arrangement, the amount of locking points that we'd got around these big flexible doors, wasn't quite what we wanted it to be. And we knew we could improve both the pull close human interface on the inside and also the fundamental action of the locking mechanism. We've just kicked off a big program of work as some more composite design resources have become available to get this sorted out for the Gen 2 fuselage. Obviously, these non-structural parts are a bit lower down the pecking order, but of great importance to the perceived quality of the aircraft. So over the course of the next few weeks, we'll be updating the structural design of the door. We'll be completely overhauling the locking mechanism, and we'll be completely overhauling the sealing mechanism to give that beautifully tightly sealed door an aperture arrangement that'll keep the perceived quality of the aircraft right where it needs to be. So really keen to get that sorted out. It's been a niggly problem for us for a little while now. So in other good news, after an extended period of development, we're now essentially complete on the detailed design and optimization of all of the crashworthy structure and the crashworthy mechanical design elements that sit underneath these beautiful crew seats. What we've done over the course of the last couple of months is fully optimized the composite structure that sits under here, fully optimized the aluminium legs that tie the seat down to the floor, designed all of the articulation that's required to allow the seat to cope with the deformations that occur in the cabin during a heavy impact, and then the tuning and optimization of the energy absorbers and the passenger restraint systems. All of that work is now done. We're currently producing a couple of final comfort demonstrator cushions. So these are foams that have been machined to accept all of that structural work underneath the seat and deliver the comfort surfaces that we want for the seat based on the latest generation of ergonomic studies that we've done. Those will then be trimmed in the final production materials and be subject to some human comfort trials to make sure that they deliver everything that we want them to do. There was a lot of really helpful feedback about these seats that we've listened to, and we've improved the overall design and comfort of the seat. Once that's locked in, it's straight down to the crash test center to validate the energy absorption and the strength of these seats in the certification crash test cases that we need for both HX and HC 50. So really excited about that. The prototype seats should be done this side of Christmas, and then the crash tests early next year, just as promised. So really excited to get those on the rig and test them.